A-Train Track 21 for Behind the Bunker. Out here at Command Decisions Warfare Center, man. This place is legit. One of my favorite places to play. Me and a few of my friends got together, got mixed it up and jiggy this weekend. We play paintball, and you're watching
Behind the Bunker!
Well, hello, guys, and welcome to episode 90 here at beautiful Behind the Bunker Studios. My name is Todd Ansich. I am your host, guys, tonight. And tonight we have lots on the show. Tonight we are going to do a quick Fold the Gap recap. I was lucky enough to go to North Carolina and see all my new friends down there and go to the Fold the Gap game, so I'll have lots of coverage on that tonight, as well as next week. Unfortunately, I didn't have a lot of time taking the Red Eye home last night, so some of the footage will have to wait till next week. We have loads of questions that we got to get to tonight. We're going to see where Behind the Bunker is the next few weeks as well on the Road Again segment. Also, we have a great video from Track 21 for when he went to the Northern Aggression game, so stay tuned for that as well tonight.
And I'm Josh Zubrickis, going to bring you lots of events tonight for paintball around the world, as well as a great segment from the international correspondent of paintball, Mr. Kakchak himself. And Skeletor sends us a great video from West Point Big Game.
Hi, I'm Joe from Flag Raiders Paintball. We have videos this week from Snarky, Beaker, Kakchak, Wolf, J-Hub, a new correspondent, 300 FPS, and a new contributor named Chris. Ooh. And we have lots of custom gear on Custom Corner this week, including something pretty sweet from Eric Engler from Engler Custom Designs. And of course, a vault segment, something of mine, something that drives, that doesn't shoot. But anyway, I will turn you over to Chris Christofferson from Kelly's Heroes.
Thank you, guys. I'm Chris. Tonight's topic, 1 year from now, what will be new or different in paintball? And tonight we feature the team Shadow Dragons on Team Feature. Play While You Stay has us going to Georgia. This and a warehouse load more on
nice.
Behind the Bunker.
Oh. First we had a boatload.
No.
A truck load.
First we had a truckload, then a boatload, then a warehouse load.
A warehouse.
Did you just crack Todd?
I did. I'm feeling bold today.
Strike one.
Bold.
This coming from the guy who just literally walked in and still has his hoodie on, as you can clearly see. So guys, as I said, we have a ton of stuff to get to on the show tonight. First of all, I want to take an opportunity to say thank you very much for all the pseudo-northern hospitality in North Carolina this weekend, guys. I met a heck of a lot of people I've only known online and those that I've never met, only just in the chat forums. It's really nice to meet you. Too many of you guys to name. I want to thank my chauffeur, Colonel Mustard, for driving me around all weekend. My general, sorry we couldn't beat the other team, beat the NATO team, but we only lost by 100 points. And thanks to all of you who shared your campsites with me, the teams that allowed me to play with them. It was pretty good. I had a really good time. So thank you for the invite down there. Now, unfortunately, these guys weren't down there this weekend, and a lot of you guys that are watching may not have been down there, so I'm going to keep it brief, but I'm going to show you a couple highlights from the trip down there. First of all, as you knew, I had to fly down there, and Colonel Mustard was my chauffeur, and this is unfortunately the scene that I saw. This is the first time I met Colonel Mustard when I came down the tram and saw.
Wow.
Yeah, so I was a little disappointed he wasn't wearing the tuxedo like the other two limo drivers were, but nonetheless, it was
nice. Kind of looks like he's getting ready to break into Gangnam Style.
Yes.
Now, it was nice, and I'm glad that he did pick me up. Unfortunately, I got to say, I was a little embarrassed in his ride. He did try, and I know he did stick
How
up
could
his
you
vehicle.
Be embarrassed to ride in that?
Awesome. Very 50s.
Got me to the style and comfort, though, I'll tell you. Now, I will tell you, one of the things that I've never seen before at a paintball field, which was really kind of cool, is in order to play on the field, you had to go through a 25-minute YouTube video or a video. And then after that, you just couldn't do that. You also had to take an online course, which could be done there in written form where you could do it online. And you can actually see, I just want to brag, that I did actually get the 100 out of 100. So there you go, guys. That is actually my Fold the Gap certificate. That's not Photoshopped in any way, because I don't Photoshop things, but that was nice.
Is it hanging on your fridge?
No, because it's on my smartphone. I did it all.
Oh, we bring it in the studio. You can put it on the fridge.
And by the way, guys, don't adjust your screen. For those of you that were asking earlier about Zuby's t-shirt or shirt, I can't do anything about it. He was at the Salvation Army this evening, and that's what he found. So,
it's pretty good.
Here's a couple quick the random picks, Matt. Flash them up. This is a gentleman I met down there. Again, there's so many of you guys, I apologize, I'm going to mess up half your name, but I but I believe his name is Jeremiah, or no, I'm just kidding, I have no idea. What's the next picture, Matt? Oh, just a random sticker. We were stickering everybody down there. Ah, one of my people that I was rolling with. You can see he has his behind the bunker sticker. Guys, I have never been to a paintball field with so many behind the bunker stickers on hoppers, loaders, all that sort of great stuff. Next picture here, obviously, you guys, this is actually my twin. I talk about him all the time, but he was down there wearing the behind the bunker hoodie, and I appreciate that. So thank you, sir, for taking all those pictures. Couple more quick random pictures. This guy here was double fisting it, as it were. You can see him with his pew-pew gun that A-Train was out in the field with tagging people with. What else do we got? As you can see, just more random behind the bunker pictures there.
And a sock.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Candies?
Mm-hmm. Cereal?
That was a cereal for the morning. Hmm. Yeah, now, because you guys were at the field, I'm going to show you a couple quick pictures that I, or a couple quick videos that I took. Matt, you can play them while we chat over them here. This is basically standing in one of their fields. I just did a kind of 360 degree, but there was well over 900 people playing. And you can see what an awesome base there is there. You can see the tanks rolling in the background there. I know it's dark there, it was late in the afternoon. But if you weren't walking uphill at that field, you were walking uphill at that field. It was...
Did they have any downhill, or was it just
no,
uphill?
No, it was all uphill, both ways, actually.
I used to walk to school that way.
And there you can see there's a couple of the tanks that I saw.
Yes.
These were some of our tanks on my squad, so that they were pretty decent.
Did they have microwaves in them? If you wanted to have a snack while you were tanking?
I believe that one had a shower in it, actually.
Oh, nice.
Mm-hmm. This one you just got sponge bathed in. So a lot of people stayed clear of that one. But yeah,
behind the bunker! Behind the bunker!
Behind the bunker!
Yeah!
Behind the bunker!
Woo! Can't tell without my glasses on.
So there you go. I took a picture of every single one of you. If you were there at the awards ceremony, now you've been on the show now. So as I say, I've got a lot of video that I've taken over the last 3 days while I was there. So we're going to get that up over the next couple weeks. I just didn't get a chance to do a lot of video editing. So guys, I would highly recommend it. I think next year I'm going to spread the word to the rest of the guys on the panel and everyone else in the studio and check that out. But that was awesome. So thank you for having us down for that. Just in case you missed it, the score was 35-50 to 34-50. It was a 4% margin. It was basically the difference of 100 points, which from what I understand was a couple of flags on some real estate that we just didn't own. So,
would you say that's a tight score?
I would say it was pretty tight. Yeah. Very nice. So why don't we move on, guys? Thanks again for everyone who invited me down, and we'll definitely see you next week. But why don't we get into our first segment? All right, so question time. Dustin, what do you have in the question department?
The first question I have here tonight is from Jeremy Nicholson. He's asking, it's been a few years with a rate of fire cap at most professional events. Has this change made professional paintball better? What about all the terms, viewability for TVs, players, retail? I support it, but I can see how it can make it less exciting for TV and less profitable for companies. Do you think the rate of fire cap was a good thing, bad thing?
So essentially they're wanting to know, because they dropped the rate of fire a couple years ago and haven't changed it, is that helping the sport or is it not? As soon as they slowed down the rate of fire, I found that the games were moving faster. Guys were staying alive off the break, a little more often, and the games were a little more exciting. When it was up to 15 balls a second, it was hard to watch. I mean, people were getting slaughtered pretty quick, and the points were over pretty fast. I don't know, but I think you're going to see something. I can't officially say, but I think you're going to see something in the PSP with their bunker set next year that's going to allow for a slower start to the game. Let me just say that, but not to say too much. But watch that, and you'll see. I don't think the rates of fire are going to change next year, but I think the field itself is going to change slightly.
Yeah. Are they going to have like bunkers?
I think they're going to have these things that they put air in front of them, inside of them. Yeah. I don't know. Do you guys have any opinions? Do you think keeping the ramping at what it is where it should be, or do you think they need to change it?
I think
get rid of it 100%.
I think they lowered the velocity. I mean, lowered the rate of fire just when the economy started to go downturn. That's why they changed the format. Instead of a timed game, they changed it to a race too. It was more affordable for people playing the game and for sponsoring teams. I think that's had a lot to do with it. Or else they would have priced themselves right out of the ballpark.
Yeah.
No pun intended.
Yeah, for sure. Dustin, you got a couple more other questions there, right?
Yeah, next one I have is from Richard Shorter. He's saying, ever since I've been having a lot of fun ever since I've joined A-Train and some of the TZB crew. What is your favorite food that is offered at our favorite and sponsored eatery, Golden Corral?
Well, we're no longer sponsored by Golden Corral, unfortunately, and thank you for putting a knife in my chest and turning it. But Joe and myself are quite big advocates for the Golden Corral. Zuby, have you eaten at a Golden Corral?
Nope.
Chris?
No, can't say I have.
I think anytime you're in, I know that they have them in Florida, but I think anywhere below Michigan, I think there's some in Pennsylvania. If anyone's Googling, find out where the closest one is to us. Maybe we need to have a field trip to Golden Corral. I don't know.
I know they don't exist in New York State. At least I've never seen it.
Growing up as a kid, I used to go to the East Coast, the Carolinas a lot with my family, and I had quite a fondness for hush puppies. So whenever I go to Golden Corral, I always have a few hush puppies.
Yeah. The problem with Golden Corral is you start on the one side and they have the delicious chicken that they have. I enjoy their fried chicken, but then you get to the next set, which is the meat segment, and they have random pieces of meat all over their barbecue and they're cooking it up. So you take a couple of those pieces and then you see their roasted chicken. And then now you have not only two of the meat groups, but you have three pieces on your plate and there's no room for the salad. I notice how they put the salad after you fill your plate. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but I would say the fried chicken's my favorite. For sure. Absolutely. Why don't we keep on going here? We'll come back to some of the questions because we have a ton to get to tonight. Tonight's show, guys, is brought to you, as always, by Empire Paintball, Air Ups Bunkers, Valken, and our friends at Die. So thanks for those guys for watching or for helping us, as well as Patchworks.
Yeah. Yeah.
So tonight's topic, guys, is... What is the topic?
What is it?
I don't know.
It's 1 year from now.
Yes, in 1 year from now, what would you
That's next week.
Forecast? I know it's wrong. What would you forecast to be something that changes in paintball for next year? What do you predict or would like to see? Our friend Wolf, sent this in. Why don't we find out what he has to say, and we'll be right back, guys.
Hey, Wolf, the game starts. Get to your base.
I'm almost there. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this edition of Behind the Bunker. My name is Wolf. I am going to be showing you a little bit of some crazy footage from the big, huge Wasega game. This week's topic is, where do you think paintball is going to be in the next year? Well, paintball, as you know, is an evolving sport. One thing that I've seen in the year of 2012 is all the new mag-fed markers coming out. I think paintball is realizing that going back to the woods is the best way to help the sport grow again, and it's getting back to its roots, no pun intended. And I think you will see a huge huge outturn of mag-fed marker play. Yes, I said magazine marker-fed because the markers are being fed by magazines. That is why it has this name. I know some people don't like that, but I'm sorry, that's just the way it is. But yeah, more tactical games, more mag-fed games, more Milsim games are on the horizon. It's going to be a lot more limited rounds games, which means not a whole hopper of paint, but limited to what you can carry in a tac cap or magazine. And we're going to be seeing a lot more tactical activity in the environment, which is awesome and makes my job that much more fun. So yes, paintball in that way I see growing a lot in a year from now, and there's some seriously upcoming products. I'm looking forward to the SAR 12 coming out and a whole bunch of the new paintball rifles that are making the Milsim game that much bigger. And there are other companies like Treyarch and all the Battlefield companies that make video games are seeing paintball as a new avenue and a new way to get out to the demographic. So they're going to be investing more into paintball also. Stay tuned, have fun, and please enjoy the sport. Hope you enjoyed your Remembrance Day and took time to remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice for their country. And shout out to all those who are still currently serving. Thank you very much. Join me on Twitter and stay tuned for the insaneness. Hey, yeah, people, this is Wolf. See you next week. Peace!
I went to the Falcon booth here at Fill the Gap, and all I got was this lousy t-shirt.
All right, very nicely done, Wolf. So guys, start thinking, what is one thing from a year from now do you think that's going to be different in
got it.
Yeah. Now, you know what? We have something new for you, Chris, as you as I sort of teased you the other day. Why don't we move right into Chris's new segment, Matt? So I just want to let you know that Chris
that
is not
nice.
Ready for his segment, although he likes his intro.
Yeah.
I sort of put him on the spot because I knew he was late and he's not prepared. So
where'd the whip go
in
to.
Line here?
We might have to come back to play while you stay.
We'll make it extra good for that, though.
Well, while you're doing that, while you're getting yourself set up, why don't we go on with our next little thing here?
Let's do
Chris.
It.
Support packages, guys. If you want to have a nice Behind the Bunker t-shirt, like the gentleman just showed in the bumper there, head on down to the bottom of your webpage and you can buy a support package as well as a barrel condom and fancy stickers for $34.99. Or you can have the same thing but included a 3D patch from our friends at Patchworks for $44.99. And all of that goes to buy a new intern who's prepared for when his segment comes up. Are you ready or should we move on to the next?
Move on to the next.
Okay.
Why don't we almost
move
ready.
On almost.
To
almost.
Player.
Clearly.
Please.
Player of the week. I have that information. Hi there, welcome back to Behind the Bunker. I will be submitting or talking about the player of the week this week, and it's the NATO MVP, I'll assume from Fill the Gap, Chris Ace Aguero, and there's some pictures of him sporting his multicam, his certificate of authenticity, his lanyard, his cap, his Tom Cruise glasses.
As when do you
well
think his flight is?
Most valuable player, and then he gets an MVP. What is that?
BBD? Most valuable player.
Yes, I know what an MVP is. Wow, you're smart.
Is that a barrel sock?
A barrel sock, or is it a head?
I reckon it's a headband.
You reckon it's a headband?
Very nice.
Reckons it's a headband. Anyway, mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Chris Ace, from NATO MVP.
Yeah. So if you guys know someone who went above and beyond, much like our intern who decided to go home. Definitely let us know. Send an email to show@behindthebunker.com.
He went into the basement.
He did.
Joe,
why are you smiling?
He went to change the furnace filter.
Why don't we move on to our next segment and give Chris time to come back up. We are talking tonight about what is the one thing that you are hoping is going to change in paintball next year. This is a new correspondent who's going to be on the show for the next little while. This is J-Hub.
Hey, I'm J-Hub, and what I think will be different, or hoping that will be different next year in paintball, is 10-man format. Come back! Please, I want it back.
Skulls and Roses, and you're watching Behind the Bunker! Yeah!
I agree with Jamie. I'd love to see 10-man come back. I know they had it at, not on my back. I said, come back.
My mustache is thinking that way, too. Wow, wow, wow.
If you unbutton your button one more, Zuby, your necklace will show. The pearl one.
Very nice. Oh.
All right, so let's move on. Tease me, will you? All right, so Chris, are you ready to go?
Not quite.
Not quite. Okay,
not quite.
So why don't we go through some of the picks that got that were sent in. First of all, I want to let you guys know if you would like to answer next week's show question, you can. We are doing an open casting call. I don't know if I had the casting call there. Yeah, there we go. Wow, we're really going strong tonight. How can you tell I was on the red eye last night? The headband that Matt was just showing, that is a new headband company called SM.
Looking at a brown-eyed girl.
And we're going to be doing a giveaway on those starting next week. So stay tuned, guys, and you'll have an opportunity to win those. Yeah, those are great. What do we have up next, Matt?
They're sexy.
Paintball Show, guys. Episode 4 is now up on our website. After our show, head on over and click on it and check them out. It is the UK version of it. It's a little bloody different than us, but check it out.
Right out.
Right. And there's Dustin. I promised every week that I show you his progress report on his mustache, and now that's week 3. So you can see it's coming in nice, and there's his fake mustache there. Dustin, if you wish, I brought this in for you as well.
Woohoo! So
if I can show that. But this is a mustache kit that you can glue on. So, yeah. What was the next picture I had there, Matt?
Tell him what type of mustache it is.
Ah, Miss Katchak. There she is. I was teasing her a couple weeks ago about getting the Behind the Bunker tattoo, and now she's actually doing it. So great. We'll have to see the end result. Zuby, you know who these guys are?
This is Chris Rose from Fireteam Gallant, Defiance Paintball, and Rudy Bontwin from Cold Blood Paintball.
Now, they're watching the show live, see what they're watching it on.
That looks like a card table. Couch.
Yes, it is a card table. It has 4 legs. Possibly, it is leaning against the wall in the corner.
It might only have 3. Maybe that's a tripod. They have those in some states.
Yeah, it looks like he's drinking Fanta as well. But yes, it is an AirUps couch. Very nice. He took advantage of the AirUps couch deal with AirUps.com. If you guys want one of those,
awesome.
Head on over to AirUps.com. They're at $185 right now. Or you can get the chair for $155. Mm-hmm. Very nice. And you could look just as smashing as these two fellows.
It's a nice looking truck in the background.
Yeah, too. And here. Chris, this looks familiar. This is your place when you're watching Behind the Bunker.
It is.
Nice.
I've got 2 little ones watching the TV there.
Get a bigger TV?
2 little cats.
Is that your TV? How big is it?
47 inches. It's not that big.
It looks
much larger.
It looks larger when in person.
Yeah. All right. And this is a t-shirt that is a Mad Frog and Crooked Concept / Behind the Bunker abomination. So this is sort of a... Yeah, I will actually show that on air next week. I have that t-shirt that was given to me on the weekend. I appreciate that. It's awesome. I will wear it next week. So stay tuned for that as well. And maybe we can get you guys to make a couple so people can buy them. I heard a couple people wanting to buy them after they saw mine. Is that all the pictures I had for now? All right, well, why don't we...
I'm almost ready, I swear.
Why don't we move on then?
2 seconds.
So tonight's topic, guys, is what's one thing in paintball that you would like to see different next year? Let's check Snarky all the way from Johannesburg, see what he has to say.
From the Book of Snark, 2nd edition. What will be different 1 year from today? Another Rap4 product will still be today. Some things in paintball easy to predict, like people's paintball gear still being nicked.
Nothing changes in the grand scheme. Paintball in the Olympics is a pipe dream. Nobody will organize and sacrifice. Nobody ever stops to think twice.
The water code for tournaments is ignored. Drug using players still get on the scoreboard. At sandbaggers I look at and I frown. Because sandbaggers hold new players down.
Die hard players will reach burnout. Local fields have a dwindling turnout. Because we're not out of the recession, leading to players' financial depression.
I wish I could give you cherry news, but a year from now we'll have the same old blues. Not players or industry thinks long term, and that to me is a concern.
Money drives the paintball game. This is the way to make things change. It's not a sport in the eyes of vendors. They see you as just another spender.
So how can things be better in a year? Well, set an example for your peers. Improve your level of personal fitness. And by realizing paintball is a business.
I think they misunderstood.
All right.
Slight misunderstanding.
Yes. Matt, this just came in. Can you go to my computer at all?
Yeah.
Something just got sent to my inbox here, guys, and I want to bring this up. Die, according to Trans World Business, has just bought Vans and Protec brand.
Really?
That's it? Just a really?
Vans?
That's pretty spectacular.
Vans
it says right
shoes.
Here. We're proud to work. We are proud of the work that Vans, registered trademark, and Protec, registered trademark, brand teams have done to build the brand globally during the last decade. Anyways, it goes on. I'm not going to read your whole article, but if you guys want to check that out, head to Trans World Business. But that was just released today.
I just bought Protec makes like skateboard helmets and stuff like that, and Vans obviously makes Spicoli shoes. So you're going to probably see a checkered Van cleat.
Very nice. So thank you to my anonymous tipster for sending that in. But I just thought I would bring that
very
to your attention.
Cool.
Very cool.
Both companies are involved in my snowboarding season.
You know, you get companies like Die now purchasing really cool companies like this, and you know, people doing good things, and then you have my intern. Are you ready yet, Chris?
I am, actually, believe it or not.
Why don't we clean this up? Let's replay his segment, Matt, and let's do that.
Hello, guys. This week's Play While You Stay was sent in to me, and we're going to Georgia, Woodstock, Georgia, to be exact. Carnage Paintball, established in 1998, formerly known as Club Paintball, in 1994, has been bringing you the best family-oriented paintball fun for over 15 years. Their staff has combined over 75 years of experience, and they are determined to make your time fun and memorable with our hospitality and competitive pricing. They are also proud supporters of the Vulcan Corps. Rental packages are available and equipment owners are also welcome. They are open Saturdays and Sundays and will accommodate private groups of 10 or more during the week by reservation. Pricing is fairly consistent with a basic field fee and air costing $10, an all-day rental package costing $30, and paint at $15 for $500 or $60 a case. For the ladies of paintball, Carnage recognizes you and offers all females half-priced rental packages for general walk-on days, and they have two girls play free days, including rentals on November 17th and 18th. Lunch is also available in two options for $5. Of course, if you need somewhere to eat that isn't a field sub or pizza, there are a number of options very close by in the downtown area. Of course, who could forget a place to crash at the end of your day? And for that, Microtel Inn and Suites offers the best bargain room for $65 a night, or your chain option Comfort Suites is also close by for $89 a night. They have a Twitter and Facebook that you can follow, as well as an emailer located on their webpage where you can receive information on upcoming events and specials. They are committed to constantly improving and stress that the owners and management have an open door policy and always want to hear your comments and feedback. Next time you're staying in Georgia, be sure to check them out.
But what if I want Golden Corral nearby?
I didn't look up Golden Corral. I didn't know Todd was going to be fixating
tonight. There's a CC's Pizza there if you turn right off the 92. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Yeah, and there's the Walmart.
Correct.
They usually have a McDonald's in there, so at least you have two options.
The mall is centrally located, you see. That's
where
most is.
Could you add Golden Corral proximity to your future?
Golden Corral. Got it.
We'd like that.
Very nice.
And driving distance from here to there.
From here to the field?
No, from
here. Or from here to the Golden Corral?
No, from here to each field.
Okay.
That would be interesting.
And just to clarify, guys, two things. First of all, whoever's got that link, they can post in the forum. People were asking for it. As well as just to clarify, guy, they just bought Protec from Vans, not Vans. I stepped on my words there. So definitely check that article and read out. Now, Matt, why don't we move on to our next segment and we'll keep this abomination going. Tonight's team feature is brought to you by Empire Paintball. Guys, tonight's team is SDI, or otherwise known as Shadow Dragons Initiative. These guys had an opportunity to play, I had an opportunity to play with them this weekend at Full the Gap, and took a quick video of them instead of me reading through. I'll let Fenway do their own introduction.
Hey, we're here with Skeletor. Who are you? Who do you play for?
Hey, I'm Finway with Shadow Dragon Initiative. I am a teammate of Colonel Mustard. Casey, here to my right, is our team captain and founder. He formed the team, and it started with the five original dragons, which are, we're missing one, and Colonel Mustard brought me and a few others on later, and we are now a force of 12 fighting crew members. That is, there's none better in the scenario world as far as I'm concerned.
Now here, out of all those members, as you told me yesterday, only three of them were actually good paintball players. And who were they?
Oh, the three that are actually good are probably these three over here. And the rest of us are just mediocre. They just make us so much better. We all look really good.
Nice.
All right. So very nice. As you can see, they quite a handsome bunch of fellows that are there. Okay, so guys, if you would like your team featured on Behind the Bunker, send us an email to show@behindthebunker.com, and we will get your team on the air. So why don't we move on, guys? Katchak has his news stories of the week. Why don't we check him out? And we still have lots to get to, guys. We have paintball around the world. We have Custom Corner, which is pretty awesome tonight. We have the Vault. We have On the Road again. We also have a video tonight from West Point, from Skeletor, as well as Northern Aggression from A-Train Track 21. These are awesome videos, so stay tuned.
Everybody, Tomcat Cunningham with the Katchak Reports Paintball News, back for another exciting edition of Behind the Bunker. Today we're down here at PRZ again for their big Die Glock game, and with me, none other than Mr. Justin Vapor Hewitt, acting captain for the Glen Morris Mercenaries, a very old, rich with tradition team.
We like to think so, yeah.
All right. You guys are down here playing today.
Yeah, and we got some numbers.
Yeah. Awesome. Now, today's question for the week, or for this particular episode of Behind the Bunker, is what can we expect that might be new for paintball in about a year's time? What do you think, Justin?
In a year's time. Right now, I see a lot of like these little companies coming out of nowhere with these mag-fed guns, and it seems like the big-name companies are starting to catch on and catch up, and they know where the industry is going with this, and it definitely seems like it's going mag-fed paintball.
Okay.
I also think, Canada is just getting bigger, especially for Ontario, for the paintball. It seems like these companies, these big-name companies, are recognizing more of these local Ontario teams, and it's just great. I love it.
All right. Awesome. I think I foresee, X number of new products for next year, markers and such.
Sure.
Valken, I understand, is coming out with a brand-new tournament series.
Really?
For 2013.
Nice to me.
We'll have to keep our eye on that. I foresee other tournament series coming out for next year. Who knows? We'll have to pay attention and watch. In the meantime, let's get some more action footage from the field. It's Tomcat Cunningham with the Katchak Reports Paintball News. See you guys on the field.
Peace.
Peace.
Now that is a sassy shirt. Where'd you get that?
I got that behind the bunker, Murdertron. Thank you much. Be sure to watch the show Monday nights. BehindTheBunker.com. 8 o'clock.
How's it going? This is Chris from Planet Eclipse, and you better be watching Behind the Bunker.
Nice.
Okay, getting ready to do a test here. Range is going to be hot. Remember, safety first. Cameras don't protect you. All right, so let's get ready to begin test.
Wait, what's that jet doing up there?
What jet?
That one up there. That doesn't look like an American jet. It looks like a terrorist jet.
What is it doing?
Wait, didn't Sonny Lopez touch your gun once?
He did.
Custom Corner is sponsored by the Damn Die Assault Matrix.
I wanted a gun that would cover everything. I want to be able to hold off 30, 40, 50 guys coming at me. I want to be able to crawl up and take snipe shots on guys.
Anything you really want in a scenario gun, it has it.
It's just a nasty, nasty tactical gun.
Hi there, welcome back to Behind the Bunker. This is Custom Corner. Each week we ask for submissions from players, people in the industry, people that like paintball, that have modified, painted, tuned up, honed, tricked out, or anything. Our first one comes to us from John Jazz Giordano.
Jingleheimer
Schmidt. Oh, it's pronounced, here it is, pronounced Giardino. Thank you. Anyway, it's an M41, a pulse rifle made popular in the movie Aliens. It's on a BT-4 combat base. It's got polished internals. There's an E-grip, a rip grip, a lapco, and a straight shot barrel. It's got a fully functioning ammo counter. Counts down from 95 to 0 under mount grenade launcher. Come and see it at the Flag Raiders Rogue Elf on November 25th. It'll be at the BT Rangers tent. And again, thanks to John Jazz Giardino.
His Fantastic. Name is my name, too.
Next comes to us from Kevin Salvation. I'm not sure if that's his last name or if his last name is Army and Salvation is his nickname. But anyway, he has Kevin Salvation. This is a custom paint job TIPX by Tipman. His sidearm looks like it has a remote line adapter nicely done in some kind of camouflage pattern. Digicam. Moving right along, this comes to us from Todd Cool Kid Davis, captain and founding member of the Maltese Militia paintball team, www.maltese/militia.com. Here is his submission for Custom Corner. Again, guys, thanks very much for your submission. It's an Empire Axe. It's got custom laser etched by Cone Sports for the Guns for the Hoses events from last year. He's the lucky winner of this one-of-a-kind marker. And he's customized it further by adding custom painted Pinocchio hopper that includes his team's logo, custom gray fade. The hopper and custom grips were done by Stringer Paintball Designs. And the last custom part is the Eye to Eye Customs barrel bag with the team logo on it. Very nice. And he's added a boss bolt to make the marker even better. Next is Terry White, aka Chrome. He works for a local Kitchener-Waterloo area OEM manufacturer in the automotive industry, and he's customized the tip of his Apex 2, and it's a shiny chrome, one-of-a-kind, one-off.
I'm just going to throw that out there. Does that manufacturer chrome rims?
Yes.
I didn't want to get him in trouble. I wasn't going to say anything.
They were custom OEM stuff for the automotive and the motorcycle industry.
We're being vague up here.
And
they just chrome. That's all I said.
Next, we also have some videos from Eric Engler. He's going to show us something pretty great.
Hello, this is Eric Engler, Engler Custom Paintball Guns. I've got a new gun I want to show you today. It's down here, and it's our minigun. Inside, you'll find the tip and phenom, and we've converted it to center feed. And of course, it all has the same function as the minigun.
I had my goggles on.
That was pretty cool, Todd. You saw that in person.
I did. Cool. That was very cool. From what I understand, Eric's going to be sending in videos for the next few weeks on all of his custom creations. So
cool.
Very cool. You had a lot of submissives on the show tonight.
Submissives?
Submissions?
Yes, because people have read 50 Shades of Paintball.
Very nice. All right, is that all we have for Custom Corner so far?
Yeah,
stay
tuned
next
all.
Week, guys. I'm going to start sending in my segment throw in there. I'm going to be customizing my dam, and you'll be seeing that over the next few weeks. We're going to show you how... Yeah, we're going to try everything we can do to make it different every week, and we'll see how long we can do that for. So,
oh, I bet a damn long time.
Mm-hmm. So, the topic of tonight's discussion is if you could change something, or if you think something's going to change in paintball over the next year, what do you think it's going to be? Guys, what are you thinking? Why don't we hit up one of you guys on the panel?
Well, don't ask me first.
I'll go if you
never
want.
Never do.
Sure.
Do you mind if I go, Josh?
See, no, for the record, I was asking him this time. Sorry. If I didn't ask him this time, he would have complained and complained. Why don't I ever
I've
ask him?
Hey, I've never complained.
I have a few ideas of what's going to happen, what you're going to see change. I think you're going to see, I'm sort of on board with Wolf's idea. You'll see not a resurgence, but you'll see a continued growth in mag-fed paintball markers. I don't know if you'll see any... newer manufacturer stepping in, but I think you'll see some changes in mag fed. You may see a resurgence in 50 caliber paintball. No, I'm just saying, just throw that in there. But what you may see as paintball continues to grow, you may see some more mergers in the different manufacturers, which we just saw, and this is between Dye buying ProTech. So you may see some more mergers and diversification within paintball. We know that Dye has entered the ski market. They also have a whole precision line where they do stuff for military, for the military contracts that not many people know about. That's where a lot of their R&D stuff is in the military contracts. But I think you're gonna see mergers in different companies.
All right, Matt, can we go over to my computer for a second?
Yep.
I'm just gonna put a stop to this right now. I'm getting trolled in the chat forum.
Hard.
There is two or three pages here. I will not say it. I spent the entire weekend in Northern Carolina or North Carolina, and I will say that your accent was thick, and I may have let one slip. I may have said a Y-bomb, but I promise I will not drop a Y-bomb tonight. I have been back with my Canadian brethren for over 12 hours, and
we're happy to have
you back.
My
accent is gone. Although I nearly let one slip today, I'll be honest with you, so stay tuned. I will do my best. Thank you all for
you
your
all.
Submissions. Why don't we move on, guys, and see what Beaker sent in his topic tonight. Let's see what he has to say.
Hey, this week's topic is, what's going to be new and different 1 year from now in the world of paintball? I'm going to say this. I have no crystal ball, can't foresee the future, but what I can say is there's going to be a lot of new jerseys, a lot of new pants, a lot of new packs, a lot of new guns, everything you want to know, pods, hoppers, things like that. This is all going to be new. We all understand that everything, there is always something new coming out. Different, hopefully there's some change that makes it, that's it, no more. We get the best of the best coming out, and we don't have to go, well, we need something else new for next year, so hopefully that all works out. I'm going to smile a lot more because I like to smile. I really do. I like to be goofy. Hopefully what's new and different is going to be reviews, interviews, getting out to fields more often, seeing people, interacting, getting to see me, knowing you, like I said, this is Beaker from Exiled Souls, member of Blues Crew. You're watching Behind the Bunker. I'll see you out in 50. Y'all take care. Be safe.
Okay, guys, one of these times we're going to cut that segment short so we can hear Zuby air guitaring and singing out loud to that song. Very nice.
Sorry, guys,
if you want Behind the Bunker to come to your event, much like we were at Folder Gap this past weekend, and help promote your event, send us an email to show@behindthebunker.com and we'll see who we can send. We have correspondents all over the world, and maybe we can send some of those, or even some of our bright and smiling faces will come down to your events. If you want to check us out, Rogue Elf, November 25th, in a couple weeks, you'll see all of us on the panel, except for Chris. I don't think he's invited, but everyone else will be at Rogue Elf, and including Jack Wan.
Well, he wouldn't show up on time anyways.
No.
10 minutes
so
late.
Definitely check that out. Or you can see Beaker at OXCC Battle of the Bulge on December 8th. We have Tom the Tomcat Cunningham and Beaker for 2012 Rise of the Atlantis at Wayne's World Grand Finale on December 1st and 2nd as well. And then we have lots more coming up as well, but we will get to those as we get a little closer. Dustin.
Yeah.
How about some more questions? We still have a stack I see over there.
Sure. The next question I have is from Philip Thomas John Marshall. And it asks, with all the MagFed kits coming out, Rap 4, MilSig, and the most recently the Die Dam Marker, what are your thoughts on them? Like the pros, the cons, your general thoughts?
You know what? That's a really good question. I've only had the Dam for a little while. I've only shot it and played for a couple weekends with it. But to be honest with you, if you're looking for more information about stuff like that, check out Tech PB. Those guys are great for comparisons and gun takedowns. Over the next few weeks, I will take the Dam out and do a little bit more of that, as well as some of those other markers you spoke of. We're going to have through the show, so you'll be able to see us doing some reviews on those. So stay tuned for now. You're a little premature on that, but we will get to some of that over the next little while.
I don't know if you're allowed to ding yourself.
Oh yeah, you can if you're premature. Ding yourself all you want.
As long as you shave your hand, your palms. Or paint your nails. Dustin, let's get out of this question and get into another one real fast.
What?
Yeah, it's
that's
your turn.
That's quick.
I bought a Spider VS2 gun, a 20-ounce Ninja Air tank. I'm assuming it's using CO2. An electric copper. I was wondering if I should buy a longer barrel. I'm not using the stock one now, and I have heard that the longer ones will make my gun a lot better. Does longer barrel really make that much of a difference?
I'll let you guys answer that. Josh, what do you think?
He's doodling.
I don't think a longer barrel makes your gun better. I don't.
You don't think so?
Well, it depends. There's such a thing as too long.
Yes, agreed.
and it depends on what type of paintball you're playing too, right? That's...
Yeah. Well, most stock guns come with a stock barrel that are
anywhere
for the
from
most part,
8 to 12 inches long.
Yeah. On a Spider, I would definitely say a 14-inch barrel would help because a stock barrel is, no offense to that company, but it's really poor. You know, when you start getting into higher end guns, you know, for example, let's say you bought the new Die gun, it has a 14-inch ultralight barrel. I wouldn't even swap out my barrel for that. But if a Spider, yes. Some of the low end guns,
sure.
Absolutely.
When I got my original Tippmann, I swapped it out with a 14-inch barrel. I personally found a difference on my gun, a little bit more accuracy, and it looks cooler too.
You have to use a decent quality paint too. If you use
That's
a crappy
true.
Paint, it really
well, my local field stocks only the best paint.
Wow.
Very nice. All right. Do you have one more question before we move on, Mr. Dustin?
Sure. This one is from Anonymous, and it says, I've been paintballing for about 4 years. I'm trying to get on a team. Can anyone tell me the requirements that it takes to be on a team? Some of the things that are simple, but I don't know, is there an age limit or anything like that.
What kind of team? Scenario team? Speedball team? I don't know.
It doesn't even have a name.
I think
it ain't that detailed.
He needs to just go hang out at the field and see what on a day on a when their teams are practicing and talk to some people running the teams and see.
Matt, someone in the chat forum answered that question for him. You can see over here, his name is Pirate, just answered it. His answer was, don't suck. If you're looking to get on a team, so it might just be that simple, I don't know.
It's a pretty general comment.
If you suck and you're with Pirate, you'll have to walk the plank.
Matt, well done, sir.
Pull your pouch over your eye like that.
Matt Sossman posted in too. He said, get a bunch of your buddies together.
Create your own team. Yeah. You know what? And that's true. I mean, joining a speedball team or a scenario team is much like, you know, looking for a new social group. I mean, these people are going to be people you have to hang around with all the time. So find guys that are, you know, that are like-minded to your interests and try not to be a tool. And, you know, start with that before, you know, forget about your skills and forget about the team that you're going to be on. Try and find guys that are, you know.
If you guys all have the same size shoes, then you can switch shoes.
If who does?
The guys on the team.
Oh, I thought you dropped the wine bomb.
Traveling shoes.
Traveling shoes.
Very good. Well, why don't we move on here, Matt?
All around the world, starring me, Josh, aka Sean 2.0.
Paintball Around the World is brought to you in part by Vulcan. Welcome to Paintball Around the World. If you have any posters you'd like to add to the show, please send it to show@behindthebunker.com. It's right down here.
We'll get it decorated.
Thank you. First poster up for today is the Turkey Shoot, happening November 22nd with, of course, the world's greatest chili.
I'm going to be so sad when this poster is out of date. We won't be able to make turkey noises.
Oh, we'll just make a poster up. And it'll be for gobble, a gobble, gobble. Tag Bray happening in South Africa, Johannesburg, the 1st and 2nd of December. No, actually, Snarky sent us an email.
Rands.
And he did confirm that, in fact, you can pay in rands, which is the currency for South Africa.
Really?
So thank you, Snarky, for sending that in. And might I say, maybe next time, not be so snarky in your emails.
I
got nothing at all on the one. No love whatsoever. Holy. Slow clap ever. OXCC is hosting the Battle of the Balls December 8th. At the Extreme Field in Chesapeake City, Maryland. Join Beaker there from Behind the Bunker. Paintball's grand finale. This is the Atlantis game happening in Wayne's World, December 1st and 2nd, with Katchak and Beaker both going to be there. And check out the Behind the Bunker sticker right in the middle at the bottom there.
Nice. That means it's a sanctioned event.
Most excellent. Yes, and also while you are there, the JT Splatmaster will be on hand and hosting a 1v1 Top Gun competition. And Operation Rogue Elf happening November 25th. Join everybody here from the cast at Flagger's Outdoor Field in Kitchener for some fantastic paintball.
And yes, Zuby will be wearing that hat.
And I will be wearing a blue one.
A blue elf suit.
Because I'm on the blue elf side. And the Vulcan Cup is coming in 2013. Stay tuned for more details.
I'm hoping to get more information on that. From what I heard, it's going to be pretty spectacular.
They've always been spectacular. So this year
is the first one.
Sure.
Yes.
Well, in my mind, they've always been good, so that's fine. Western Wars. Barney taking on the Tomcats at EMR, happening June 29th and 30th next year.
Is Tomcat the engine one?
No.
Tomcat is playing Native Americans, I believe.
No, no, he's the colonel, and you can see that Barney is the one with the headdress.
Oh, purple feathers.
I get it.
There was a parade in Toronto this summer that I saw someone wearing those in.
You were there?
I was.
Scary. Crusades 2013 happening at Shoreline Paintball. It's going to be a fantastic event as they take you through multiple crusades over multiple weekends, capped at 300 people. Looks really, really good.
Yeah, yes. So what if I had a poster I wanted to send in?
You could send it to show@behindthebunker.com. Make sure you stop by our Facebook page, get the logo, put it on your poster, and send it on in.
But wait, show@behindthebunker.com, that's the same place I would send my custom
corner submission.
And your team feature.
And your play while you stay.
And your player of the week. Everything goes at Show Behind the Bunker.
Wow, that's one big mailbox.
That inbox must be massive.
I knew that was coming before it even. All right, so why don't we move on, guys? Skeletor 262, we haven't seen him for a little while, but he submitted a video this week, which is a good one. I had a chance to look at this. West Point Classic. After watching this video, I think this is an event that I would like to see next year, but check this out, guys.
When the drum beats go like this.
twice when you play paintball.
Epic game. We're out of here.
All right, Carlos, little baby got hurt.
I'm Jody from Deadbox and Magwell, and you're watching Behind the Bunker.
Nice!
Nice! Alright, so guys, if you are interested in maybe, winning one of these fantastic Behind the Bunker head wraps, as you can see how handsome it makes everybody look, very nice. Stay tuned, guys, next week on the show, and we will let you know how you can possibly win it. Now, you know what? I forgot to do something
do
at the beginning of the show. Just want to say thank you to the guys at Deadbox. I'm enjoying the new shirt. And Joe, I brought a couple things I forgot to give you as well. This here is from
Goodies?
Mr. Mustard.
Ah!
Fine. Yeah.
Awesome. Look
this is that. From Psycho Scenario. Quote unquote, changing the face of paintball. No pun intended.
Oh, that's pretty cool. This is my gas mask modification.
That's cool.
Yeah.
It puts the lotion on itself. It's awesome. I'll put that on. Thank you very much, guys. That's so fantastic.
Creepy. Yeah. Now, here's very that exciting. Shirt that I was telling you guys about. I'll wear this one next week. I just want to make sure I...
May I see it?
Yeah. This is my Behind the Bunker
behind
shirt.
Behind the Bunker.
And now this one here...
Where's that
that's very cool.
This one here says...
Pew, pew, pew.
Paintball around the world. And it says Zuby on the back.
No way.
I wonder if that would fit anybody.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah. And who do you think that's from?
Well done.
Mad Frog.
And
Crooked Concepts.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Awesome.
I like that.
So very nice as well.
I like it too.
So thank you very much, guys, for that. I also want to say thank you again to my friend Greg. I was going to show you that a little bit later on, but he gave me a Splatmaster. What is neat about that Splatmaster?
It's a thing.
It is a side-cocking Splatmaster. Forward.
It is.
Yeah.
Very nice.
So very limited run on those. And the other thing I wanted to show you was, this is another shirt I got from the guys at Deadbox. This says MagFed, do more with less. And I got it in your size, so you'll be able to
wear
that as well.
Thank you very much. Very kind of you.
Yeah, look at that. Lots of prizes and gifts and swags for all of our all of our friends
down there. The
swaggery. Mm-hmm. Now, since we're all feeling cocky here in the studio, with our new headbands on, Dustin, why don't we answer yet another question?
I have a question here. Are you all right?
I hit Joe's foot, not yours.
That's right.
All right, I have a question here from Sean. And it reads, it's been a very long time since I've played, like about 16 years. I'm a little old, LOL. Anyways, I'm thinking about playing again. Scenarioed field, you know, just generic. I'm looking at the A5 based on some of the recommendations from some of my soldiers who actively play. We are currently deployed now, so playing within the next 10 months isn't really an option. My question is there a weapon coming out within the next year that I should wait for on? I can purchase an A5. I've also considered an X7, but I was told there isn't much difference between the two, and the X7 is slightly bigger and a little bit more bulky. Is something on the horizon that I need to be aware of? Please let me know. Thanks, Sean.
What do you guys think? I'll let you guys jump in on that one.
A5.
Oh, sorry. I was daydreaming about Sonny Lopez.
I thought you were going to talk me into a PCS.
I started with the clone, and when that turned into a shovel, I went with the real thing, and that was the best move I made.
Now, he also didn't mention the Phenom.
That's clone?
Of the A5.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You should probably point that out.
I was looking to get into Tippmann, the X7 and the A5 were the two that were kind of, from Tippmann anyways, that were in close competition. And as you were informed, I did not find a whole lot of difference between the two markers. And actually, I found the X7 a little bit heavier and, as you mentioned, a little bit bulkier. So I ended up going with the A5. I really like it.
Well, there you go. There's the answer to your question.
I don't have to take it apart every game.
And you know, if it's coming from an intern, you know it can be true.
Of
right.
course, right?
It's on the internet.
He's not allowed
and
to
I'm wearing a headband. So guys, now why don't we move on? This is Clint from 300 FPS sent in his submission this week on the topic, what would you think is going to be different, or what would you like to see different in a year from now in paintball?
This week's topic is, what's going to be new in 1 year from now in paintball? Well, I thought about it, and I couldn't think of anything, so we've been working on this device right here, and I'm going to test it out today for all of you so I can get an answer on this. It helps me see into the future. I don't want to repeat what I just saw. Anyway, the only thing I could think of is, I hope paintballs get bigger again, because they've been getting smaller for so long. It seems like all of us have kits and barrels and everything that we can't use anymore because the bores are too big. So I'm kind of hoping that paintballs increase in size, not decrease like they have been.
So very well done, Clint. So the topic tonight, guys, is what would you think is going to change in the year, or what would you like to see change in a year for paintball? Zuby, what are you thinking?
What I'd like to see is behind the bunker get a little bit bigger. We can use a chip-in widget and some more support packages so we can buy that Cessna we had our eye on this past weekend and maybe get out to a few more paintball games.
Yeah. Maybe we shouldn't have bought the hangar first.
Yeah. Playing the hangar in front of the plane.
Or that gigantic bucket of animal crackers.
Yeah. So yeah, that's an option. Chris, do you have any thoughts?
Last week, I don't want to repeat anyone else's idea, but I do agree with Wolf that as a mostly scenario player, MagFed is something that's becoming more and more of an interest to me. I think you will only see that grow. And become more accessible to more players. So I think that would probably be the number one thing that I see coming up for next year. Yeah,
for sure. I agree with you, Zuby, as well as Bane in the chat forum. I believe that Behind the Bunker will get bigger next year from some of the projects that Joe and I are going to be doing in the next couple of months that you'll hear about. And with the hookups with all our new sponsors, I believe that the show is going to increase in size this year and become something maybe a little bigger than what it is. Not too much bigger, because we do this because we have fun, and if it changes anything else from that,
most of us have fun.
Yeah. There's shut up, Chris. So we're going to move on. My thoughts on what we're going to change. Definitely, I will agree with the MagFed. I think with the advent of Die coming out with MagFed guns, as well as Spider and all the other traditional companies coming out with, it only stands to reason that over the next year we'll probably see something from, Empire. We might see something from Valken and more manufacturers doing the MagFed or strictly MagFed companies coming out with even more markers. So I assume that's going to happen over the next little bit. Yes, you can all, yell at me in the chat forum, but I believe Airsoft is going to get much, much bigger over the next little while. I heard stories last weekend where they had a big airsoft game at Foldagap the week prior to their game, and they had over 1,000 people. This is not unheard of. These games are out there, and they're growing in size, and I believe that the airsoft market is going to grow much, much larger. Now, hopefully the MagFed market will grow from that.
I think you'll see. We'll have an offshoot show, and it'll be called Behind the BB.
It'll be a much smaller show, though.
It'll be smaller, and it'll be for the airsoft version.
Behind the Immaculate.
And it'll be airsoft around the world, and it'll
No, it won't.
Airsoft where you stay.
Zuby's taking a stand.
I also think with the economy being the way it is, and people slowly starting to spend more money, and companies doing a little better, I think you're going to see a lot more corporate outings at local paintball fields. So either if you work at a field, you'll see that, or your company, you might have better luck talking to HR and getting groups out to paintball fields now that companies are starting to loosen their belt a bit. The other thing I think is going to increase is you're going to see UWL grow in size. I had an opportunity to finally see it at World Cup, and I have to say, I want to play the UWL. I know it's expanding into Europe. I know there's grumblings of it coming into Canada. It's going to move pretty quick when it does. So watch for UWL over the next year as well. But so why don't we keep moving on here, guys? We still have the vault to get to. We have all kinds of things to get to. And thank you, SR Voodoo, in the chat for agreeing with me. That gave me a little warm fuzzy there. So thank you. Other than that, why don't we move on, guys? Joe, you have something from the vault.
Oh, I do.
You want to segue that?
We're going to start the vault. Each week I do something old, something that I have. This week isn't really paintball, but I have used it for paintball. It's my 1974 Mutt, military utility truck tactical. It's a Jeep. Well, it's after the Jeep, but it's made by AM General. It has a Ford engine, and it predates the Humvee. So these were put in service in Vietnam until 1983. Colombians have a bunch.
Here's my Jeep after its very nice paint job. See it. It's quite good. Quite magnificent, actually. A very good job. Everything's painted inside. Got some stuff inside. Everything's been painted and cleaned and baked. The back's fixed up. It's pretty spiffy. Dashboard's been done. Put the data plate back on. Everything looks good.
So that's something I've had for a while, and I just had it at a body shop, and they just gave it to me. They painted it and fixed some of the holes in it, and it's pretty rare. It's a pretty rare piece. The Americans, when they decommissioned them, they cut them into pieces. This one is uncut, so it's a completely uncut version, unit body. So yeah, it's pretty cool. So I'll have it out at the field for our Vietnam
games. So essentially
games.
They didn't clip it.
They didn't clip it, yes.
The chat form wants to know, are those lawn chairs for
car
seats?
No, it's a military vehicle. It's very utilitarian, and I have seat covers to pull over. It's like riding in.
Someone's asking if it runs.
It does run. It's like riding in a wagon with a lawn chair in it, and you're sitting on top of the gas tank. There's no seat belts. It's four-wheel independent suspension, and it's not, safe, but it's cool.
And there is a clutch in it, technically, but when you drive it, there really doesn't feel like there's a clutch
and
in it.
And it doesn't have high and low. It just has four-wheel drive, not four-wheel drive. And there's no key ignition, so you just, like any military vehicle, you just press a button to start it, and you lock it.
Zuby, I've got six people in the chat forum wondering why you're texting during the show.
Whose phone keeps going off?
It's not mine.
Yeah, social butterfly over here.
I just accepted the invite to next year's Fight for Asylum 2 at PRZ.
So guys, we're going to move on here real quick. We have another, this is a new contributor to the show. I would like you guys to all
stand.
You all.
Y'all.
Welcome, Christopher. Let's see what Christopher has to say on today's topic.
Hey guys, Tech here. Welcome back to Behind the Bunker. This week's question, 1 year from now, what do you think will be new or different in paintball? I think that milsim is going to explode within this next year. See a lot more guys out at your field dressing up like they're in the military, you know, tactical vest, full camo, magfed. People are going to be shooting a lot more magfed markers compared to hopper fed. People are going to enjoy having first strikes, trying to be more like snipers, just things like that, you know. Milsim's going to explode in this next year. Thanks for watching Behind the Bunker.
Thank you.
Right, well so I done. Have to say, Chris, bravo.
Welcome,
well done.
The namesake
to,
did proud.
Yes. He's a, what is he, a junior apprentice? Or
he might actually pick up some of your slack.
He's a co-op student.
Yeah, co-op student.
You're an intern. There's only one Chris intern spot student, here, man. So. Well done, Chris. Keep them coming in and just keep it simple. All we want to hear is your opinion, and that's great. Now, is that the new JT jersey I've heard so much about? I like that. Very nice. Keep it old
hey,
school,
Todd,
my friend.
It's not nice that you're wrapping up that duct tape to send him.
Shh, that was supposed to be a surprise.
Yeah. So we got a couple more things to get to tonight. We still have the Northern Aggression from a video from Track 21, which is pretty fantastic, that I want to show you guys before the end of the show. And Dustin, you still have a couple questions left in the question area.
Yeah, I do.
Yes, I do?
Yes, yeah, I have a few questions left in my entourage of questions. Do you want me to ask one right now?
We would like
no, I just brought it up because I was just wanting to know.
Okay.
Chilly.
Well, I do.
It's kind of cold.
All right. Next question, again, anonymous. I got a BT4 about 6 weeks ago. I've been firing it in my backyard. It started to sound like it was shooting, like almost machine gunning, and then failed to recock. After that, I thought, you know, it's a fluke. I'll try it again, and it did it again. Any ideas, or do you think I should just take it to a shop and get a test?
Are you using CO2?
Where I don't think he's going to answer because he faced up this
time.
Fair enough. I might need a little bit of lube. It sounds like it could be the hammer O-ring. You might need just to drop a couple of drops of paintball lube on the O-ring, and you'll be able to do that right through the slot where you cock it. It could be wear on the sear, but unlikely. And if you're in an area that's cold, like this, our studio,
it's a little bit nippy in here.
It is nippy, and. If you're, Dustin
yes,
was just touching
my
himself.
My shirt's getting cut.
He thought
actually.
He was Jack. Anyway, if you're in an area that's cold and you're using CO2, it may be turning to a liquid and you're not getting enough recocking pressure, no pun intended, or your tank might be empty.
I was going to say that. We're reading too much into this question. If you hear the way he says it, he's playing with his gun and then it happens, and then he cocks his gun and it happens again. It could just be the fact that he ran out of CO2.
Oh, he's
or
excited.
He very much so.
It just went off.
Wow, really?
That just happened. Just right happened. There.
Yeah, we'll give you a moment to refill your drinks.
Yeah, for all of you who's playing along at home, thank you.
That's your home game. All right, we have time, Matt, for maybe one more question. Okay. That's you, Dustin.
Yeah. Zumi, did you see the post in there?
I'm trying to read all of them.
It said, it's easier to test by touch than sight.
Okay.
Nice. Oh.
You're still looking.
No, I saw it.
All right. I have a question here from Christopher Cathiro, and he's asking, I'm from Guyana in South America. I asked, when using hanging scales or over tabletop scales for CO2 filling, which one's better? Never seen it covered on the show or any information on it.
We
talked
a hanging,
about that a couple weeks ago,
hanging,
actually.
Yeah. Hanging scale, yeah. But don't drink the Kool-Aid.
Digital scales are great, but a lot of them are programmed to not refresh fast enough. So what you want to do is use a manual hanging scale that has a spring. So as it fills, you can actually see the gauge moving. And then also you can tell by the rate of the gauge moving how fast you're filling. So you may want to slow down on the handle if it's going up too quick. But we talked about that on a couple shows ago as well about the scales and stuff. So we dumped
no,
the mechanical scale.
No one got it, Wolf. Maybe Simon got it, but that's about it, Wolf.
What's the question?
Kool-Aid joke.
We got it. Well, we're under contract not to laugh at it, though.
Guys, what we're doing is we have about 100 people in the chat room right now, and it's moving really quick, and we're reading it, and we're interacting with it. So if you're
most
not getting anything
flaming talk
at home that you're not that we're talking about, it's because we're trying to interact with the guys in the chat forum. And guys, I want to say thank you to everyone that's in there. It's nice to see our regulars in there, as well as some new people as well.
Drink the Kool-Aid, you're going to have a bad time.
Very good. I think maybe what we should do for next show is turn this off, because you've definitely got Zuby's number tonight, guys. Very good.
Does that get dinner?
All right, so Zuby, what do you have to promote before we move on to our final video?
Paintball around the world, of course. If you have any events that are coming up at your local field or your local field's on here watching the show, send it in to show@behindthebunker.com. Stop by the Facebook page, grab the Behind the Bunker logo, put it on your poster.
Sounds like too complicated for me. And guys, if you're
new
in the chat form, because I see a bunch of you in there,
Post up on the show. Post up in the forum here what you think of the show tonight, and be gentle because we do tear up quite easily. Joe, what are you thinking? What do you need to promote for next week?
I'm promoting Custom Corner. If you have anything modified, painted, tricked out, done anything to in your paintball arsenal or your paintball wardrobe, like a cool mask modification or something, please take a picture or two and submit it to show@behindthebunker.com and we will put it up on the show. But please tell us your name and where you're from and where you play and we'll get it up there.
Now, in the chat room, SR Bain is asking when are they going to get Brody back. Brody's not going to be back for a while. He's down in the States filming Breaking Amish. So when that series is finished, he may be back on the show, but he might be too big for his britches at that point and not want to come back to the show. Chris,
Hold on one second. Why is everyone saying I need to play for Smash? Everyone in the chat is saying I'm playing for Smash.
Brody's too busy trying to sell the Eagle.
So Chris, what do you have to promote for next week?
Well, guys, this week's Play While You Stay was submitted by a field owner in Georgia, and I loved not having to do the work, but more importantly, I loved having someone tell me about their field. If you want your field featured on the show, please send some info, pictures, and general prices to show@behindthebunker.com, and we'll make sure to get it on.
And keep in mind, our spam filter picks up any of those pictures.
That's very true.
Pictures, please.
Official pictures only. And last thing, for the people that were asking in the chat form, yes, everyone on the panel is participating in Movember, especially this dirty stash right here.
We actually have sponsored the local Movember, KW Movember has a charity fundraiser ball, and Flag Raiders Paintball has sponsored a table at the casino night. It's an 80s themed. And we will go in dressed in our best Tony Montana. Mm-hmm. Whatever.
Well done.
Like it, yeah.
Well
like
done, yes. Yeah, and some of us are trying very hard to grow a mustache. My mustache seems to have migrated down to my chin. I'm still a 14-year-old boy, apparently, and can't grow a mustache. So I will keep trying, and we'll see what happens before the end of the week. Do we still have Dustin's close-up map that we can show people? Just as people get a... Yeah, there you go. So you can see it's starting to really fill in there on his upper lip. Very nice. All right.
I was trying to update my picture for day 12. Yeah.
Day 12. Put it on eHarmony. Nice.
It's actually coming. Like, I'm trying to do the whole curly cue thing.
It's coming in really well. Do you know how long that actually takes?
I don't know. I'm going to grow it in.
You should have started about 3 years ago.
I know.
This is going to be more like Mo 12.
Yeah.
So very good, guys. We're going to move on right now and end the show with a segment from Track 21. From A-Train's video of Northern Aggression. Before we do that, I want to say one last time thanks to y'all that I met down in North Carolina at Fold the Gap. It was nice to see all of you down there. And that was twice.
Chat's closed.
Very nice. I definitely had a great time, and thank you for the invite, and hopefully we'll see you again next week. And yes, now the chat's going crazy because I messed up. So, brilliant. Other than that, guys, thank you very much for the support. Thank you for all the guys that are buying support packages and chipping in on the Chip and Widget. It's definitely helping out. Thanks to our sponsors, Die, Patchworks, Valken, AirUps, JT Empire, and Battle Tested. Without you guys, the show would not be on the air at this point. I basically rolled Chris and got all the money I could out of his pockets, and that's it. We're at the end of our fundraiser. So whatever you guys can do to help would be great. And guys, please help advertise the show. Put them on your Facebooks, tweet them, Instagram them. ICQ them, whatever it takes to get the information out to your friends.
Blast from the past.
Maybe it's a regional thing, but we had this conversation around the campfire this weekend about ICQ, and there are people down there that are still using it. So
there's a new one too that I just downloaded.
JCB?
Alien Blue.
Ah.
Anyone use Alien Blue?
We're going to sit here and wait. Come on, guys.
Anyone?
All right, guys, so we're going to move on the show. So thanks you all for watching. Thanks to the guys in the panel for being on the show. Thanks to the guys in the broadcast booth. Thanks to Matt and Dustin who are continuing their off-air conversation right now. And we will see you guys next week. So stay tuned and check out this video from Track 21. And we'll see you guys next week. See y'all.
What's up, it's the A-Train, it's Track 21 from Behind the Bunker here with my good friend
Chris Hazard, the Canadian Honey Badger, Track 21.
We are down here in Perry, Georgia at Big Indian Paintball for
Northern Aggression, baby, north versus south.
And we are kicking it in all weekend, wonderful weekend of paintball. This place is awesome. right off the highway. Like, right off the highway.
One left.
Adrenaline Army's out here playing, getting ready for World Cup. The kids are out. Lots of new people into the game. And we really cannot complain about the weather.
Woo!
Oh, man. Good. Jamie, thank you for having us down to your home state and your home field for a great weekend of paintball. All right, so let's get the cameras rolling. The gun's rolling, and actually, all three of us are rolling. Vanguard Demons. And let's go play with these kids, have a great time, watch Adrenaline Army get ready for World Cup, and we're gonna show you Big Indian Paintball, all right? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks for having us. And at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter how many points are gained or lost, because any day of playing paintball is better than something else.
Heavenly Father, we give thanks for this day, wonderful day. Thank you for everybody that showed here. We ask you to use blessings to keep us safe and have an honorable game. We do all these things in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. All right, let's go play some paintball.
Yeah.
How do you stay P5?
Like a boss. Like a champion. That's what.
Back in that building, Frank. Back in that building. Oh, I got him. I got him. Come on, get over there. I know I hit you. Yeah, there you go. Come on, check it. Check it. See out. Check it. Thank you.
Say hi.
What's in your heart that counts in this game? Don't worry about all our flashy guns.
Don't know. On. Don't know. On.
You know, if you got any bullies or some guys try to mess with you, you can ask me, Miss Jamie, Mr. Hazard, or any one of our friends. And all my friends, raise your hand. Paintball doesn't allow bullies, okay? That's right, you're a little hero too. You stick up, I saw you doing it. Keep your goggles on, your barrel bags on, so you're nice and safe, and you disrespect people on that field, okay?